बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन कैम्प बूस्टर विद दिया शहजादी। आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू विद न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज द रदरफोर्ड एटॉमिक मॉडल इन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम। एज वी आर स्टडिंग द डिस्कवरी ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन, प्रोटॉन एंड द न्यूट्रॉन, आफ्टर दैट देयर इज अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज द रदरफोर्ड एटॉमिक मॉडल। द रदरफोर्ड रदरफोर्ड वॉज अ साइंटिस्ट। He wants to clear that what was the structure of the atom actually. He knows that the plum pudding theory was not a correct theory. According to the plum pudding theory, that was the like this theory, atoms have a central part that is a positively charged and surrounded by the negatively charged ions. He take a gold foil and the thickness of that gold foil was 0.004 centimeter, and he used the alpha particles to just to pass from this gold foil and want to see the results, what was the discovery of the last discoveries about the plum pudding theory was correct or the not. He observed that the alpha particles, and he wants to secure the results, and he used the graphite plate are the zinc sulfide plates as a screen in the center or the next part towards the alpha particle, so he can check the result after the deflection of the alpha particles, then after towards the gold foil, and he proves that the plum pudding theory was not right. Here is a setup that was just to set about to check. Here is an alpha particle that was inserted towards the gold foil, and here in the behind this there was a graphite screen or the zinc sulfide screen to show the results, whether these results were positively and the negatively. Okay, when the alpha particle hit the center of the atom, there was a dense and a solid thing that deflected the rays towards the its basic part that from they were originated, and the some was deflected at the large angles and some was deflected from the low angle, and majorly they were all of the he used that more than 20,000 alpha particles to bombard on the gold foil. The result was that some of them was just deflecting from any without any angle, just passing from the structure of the atoms and not deflecting and producing the fluorescence on a screen that was the zinc sulfide screen at the behind screens part of the experimental structures. Here is a two-dimensional structure, and when we see the three dimension of this, here will be a screen or a plate to just check the result of that. When the alpha particles were bombarded, the three conclusions are the three things were majorly considered. Let's move towards them. Rutherford made some assumptions and the observations while he was performing his experiment. He said that almost all particle was passed through the coil, so undeflectedly. That was this assumption, or that was the proof of that the most of the part of the atom is empty, and out of the 20,000 particle only few were deflected at the large angle and few were deflected at the low angle. Result: what should be the results of this experiment? Because he said that the most of the particles was undeflectedly passed, so the volume of the nucleus or the atom was empty, and the deflection of the few particle produces that the center of the positively charged atom, which is called the nucleus, that is a dense. The complete rebouncing of a few particles showing that the nucleus is very dense and the hard, so that's why the reflection, the alpha particle was not deflected, but these were deflected. Few particles were deflected, and it showed that the size of the nucleus is very small because it was comprises on a very small place. So the particles was bombarded in the lines that was a continuously. They were falling on the alpha particle in the gold foil paper, and the results were that the nucleus is a size of the nucleus according to the size of atom is very low. So here is a proof that nucleus can exist, but the size of the nucleus is a low. Atom as a whole is a neutral, therefore the number of electrons in atom is equal to be the number of the protons. except the electrons all over the fundamental particle that were lie in the nucleus, they were known as the nuclei. This is the basic definition of the nuclei, that they accept the electrons. Electrons are those that are not inside the nucleus. They are revolving electrons. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. These are the electrons and the other particles like the proton and the neutron that are present in the nucleus. These are called the nucleus. There was about as the success with their defects of the Rutherford experiment, as he proved that the plum pudding theory was not right. Also, there was some mistakes that he made in his experiment, and according to the classical theory of the radiations, electron begins being the charged particles should be released or the emit the energy continuously, and they should ultimately fall into the nucleus. In the classical theory, and Rutherford also said that there is a classical behavior of the electrons. It was revolving, electrons are revolving in the nucleus, around the nucleus, and when they are revolving around the nucleus, then at a certain time, their electrons should be fall into the nucleus and the atom should be destroyed. There should be the no existence about the nucleus according to the classical theory. But if the electron emit the energy in a continuously spectrum, thus they should form the continuously spectrum. But the result or the actual spectrum that was made by the atom, that was the line spectrum. Although the scientist had objections on the atomic model that was presented by the Rutherford, but yet it contributed that the proving the ideas of the wrong among them. He invited the questions. A different type of the questions was arised in the mind of the scientist, that if the atom has nucleus, electrons and protons, and the size of the nucleus is small, electrons are revolving around the nucleus, and what was the questions, these were what were the thing that the electron is not a continuously spectrum, and they are not producing according to classical theory that are not releasing the energy. So what was the actual behavior of the atom in the structure? The three questions were majorly disturbing the scientist, and they posed them to work on the structures of the atoms. How can atom collapse? The atoms, why the atoms are the stable when they are releasing their energy continuously according to the classical theory? These were the questions. And why does an atom give up a line spectrum, as well as he can give us the continuously spectrum, because these are the continuously emitting the energy? These were the questions that was making the confused towards the scientist, and posed them to work further on the structure of the atom. Here is a defect, that according to the classical theory, electrons are revolving around the nucleus, and at some time electrons should have to radiate, as they are radiating their energy and becoming close to the nucleus, and at the end of their existence, there should be that the electron fall into the nucleus and their nucleus will be destroyed, and there is a no existence about the structure of the atom, and that was a wrong. Atoms exist. Here is a time to test yourself. Why? What was the reason behind this, that the aluminium foil is used in the experiment of the Rutherford? For the objections of the further experiment, that was the structure, basically performing the structures of the atoms. And what were the defects of the Rutherford experiment, and what are the three questions, and how arised front in defect of the Rutherford model. Take care of yourself and others, and never forget to subscribe, like and share my videos with your friends. This will be just for supporting me. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself and others. Allah Hafiz.